What's up, basketball fans? Welcome back to Timeout. With me, Rocky Padilla, and on this episode of Timeout, I'll be talking about the ABL ASEAN Basketball League. There were three games last night. The first one was Cheongsun Kung Fu against Westport's Malaysia Dragons. Cheongsun won 96-81. I think Cheongsun is a legit contender for the ABL Championship. They are really good, especially with their import Anthony Tucker, who had his second straight triple-double with 22 points, 10 rebounds and 12 assists. And this is the first time in the ABL a player had a back-to-back triple-double. So Anthony Tucker, this guy is, I never heard of him, but now after three games, I've been watching his game, he's really good and he can pull up from the three-pointers. So this guy is playing for the best import in the ABL. And then they also had Justin Howard. Justin Howard had 31 points last night. Plus their local Kai Guo, I don't know how to pronounce his name, but hopefully it's right. Kai Guo, it had 19 points and 7 rebounds. Plus their heritage import, Kalen Tiongson, hopefully I say that name right too. He is a very good heritage import, lockdown defender, which means last night, Westport Malaysia Dragons import, Marcus Marshall, who had 60 against Manu Vampire. Last night was struggling with his shots. He only made 3 shots from 17 attempts, but he still finished with 16 points last night. But that was a Tiongson made it tough for Marcus Marshall last night. So that was from the Dragons and Cheongsun game. So let's move on to the second game where Singapore Slingers beat Ala Pilipinas 97-83. Little surprise for me, because I thought Ala Pilipinas, after losing a close game to Hong Kong Eastern, they're gonna came out with a very high energy and they are hungry for a win. But last night they struggled a little bit, I think, and then Singapore Slingers took advantage with their import Xavier Alexander, who killed the Ala Pilipinas with another triple-double also. Xavier had 27 points, 11 rebounds, 12 assists, and 4 steals. And his countermate, Ryan Wright, had 24 points and 18 rebounds, plus a big help from Han Bin with 18 points and 6 rebounds. So now Ala Pilipinas is 0-2 to start the season. And this is gonna be I think Coach Jimmy Alapak will do a lot of adjustment for the next game, because I don't think they expect this kind of start. So I'm hoping that Alap could bounce back next game and get a win. For the Slingers, they are now 2-1. I think for the Slingers, this is a good sign, because they always trust their locals. They're always about the local development players. So this is a good sign. They could beat Ala Pilipinas. That means they could compete for a championship also this season. So big ups to Xavier Alexander. This guy he can do everything. I like his game a lot. X-Men is killing it this season. So hopefully he could keep it up for the Slingers. So now let's move on to our team, CLS Knights Indonesia. CLS Knights struggled last night, and then they lost the game 98-85. I think the problem was just the first half. They came out with a low energy. They got no sense of urgency. So they were down 64-37 in the first half. Mano was on fire off the gate. They hit their first 6 three-pointers. And Paul Zamar, Reggie Johnson, and then also Jason Brickman killed CLS Knights Indonesia in the first half. But I like how CLS Knights came out in the third quarter. They had 6 straight stops. They trimmed down their deficit, but it was too big of a deficit to catch up again. But I think this is another good lesson, that when you play on the road, you have to come out with a sense of urgency, and then also sorry to speak in Bahasa a little bit, but also the right energy, because you cannot you know, fall behind that much and then try to come back in the second half, that will be tough. But B-Boy is coming next game, I think, because yesterday I think they want B-Boy to stay in Surabaya, take a rest after the Jawa Post tournament. So B-Boy gonna play on Sunday against Hong Kong Eastern. Gotta be a tough task, but they're gonna play at home. So yesterday, Brian Williams led in three categories, I think, 25 points, 15 rebounds, and 6 assists. Brock helped with added 16 points, and Freddie Goldstein added 17 points. Now, nobody from the local players had double-digit points, but I think when they come home on Sunday, play against Hong Kong Eastern, they need somebody to score double-digit at least. So we're hoping that Sandy or Mario Wusang. Mario had a bad shooting night yesterday too, so hopefully we need somebody to bounce back and help the imports, because CLS Nets need the local players to help in order to get a win in the ABL. So hopefully B-Boy also gonna be a big help on Sunday, because B-Boy has the experience playing international games and he has a very good skill set also. For everybody that asking me about Alex Zhao, Alex Zhao is a former, I think, a walk-on from Penn State University. I have no idea if he's coming or not. We're gonna wait and see. But yeah, that's all about the ASEAN Basketball League yesterday. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know if you want me to keep doing all these ABL updates. And don't forget to like this video and comment and subscribe my channel if you haven't. And thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.